chapter 17, 1 to 6. Okay, let us read it together. Now Elijah the Tishbite from Tishbe in Gilead said to Ahab, "As the Lord the God of Israel is, whom I serve, there will be neither dew nor rain in the next few years, except at my word." And the word of the Lord came to Elijah, "Leave here, that means the word, and I mean the fear, I mean, is spoken written. You will drink from the brook, and I have directed the ravens to supply you with the food there." So he did what the Lord had told him. He went to the area ringing east of the Jordan and stayed there. The ravens brought him bread and meat in the morning and bread and meat in the evening, and he drank from the brook. Amen. Hallelujah. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. And I hope everyone will receive the Holy Spirit and the spiritual word through the Bible. And then I'd like to ask all of you, how can we leave this world? We need support by others or neighbors. In my case, when I was in the US 2009, at Emory University, I was at that time a graduate student to study the Bible, the Old Testament. At that time, my grammar and pronunciation, still I'm improving, but the pronunciation, the writing skills were not good. That's why I need somebody, a proofreading for my articles. So every day, I pray to the Lord, "God, please send me, like today, the scripture ravens, to help me." And then in the class, I entered, and somebody I could see, and she, the African American, she is bigger than me, and sometimes I'm scared when I met her. And suddenly she came to me, and she smiled at me, and she said, "Do you need my support, my help?" I didn't ask for her at all. I think God responded to my prayer, and she came to me, and she helped me in the proofreading for my articles without any payment. Then, for a cup of coffee or tea, we drank each other, and she helped me like ravens. That time, I don't know, that time I kind of biased, or, you know, she is, you know, bigger than me, than African American, and I scared at her, but God used her like ravens. So today's scripture talking about God's delivery by ravens. So I would, you know, as a Bible, a biblical scholar, I'm very interested in the Elijah and Elisha narrative. You know, the total the chapters from 1 Kings chapter 17 to 2 Kings chapter 13. The total number is 19. 19 chapters talking about Elijah and Elisha narratives. When you open the Bible, the story of the 1 Kings and 2 Kings, we might think, oh, focusing on only the kings. But here, Elijah narrative, prophets, the story of the prophets. What is the story telling us? The story is very, very important to understand God. Who is God? Who is our real God, true God? So let us think about the meaning. The first, let us read together. Ready? Go. God gives his blessing. God gives his blessings. And Elisha narrative begins with chapter 1 Kings chapter 17, begins with the issue of rain. So let us read again. Now Elijah, the Tishbite from Tishbe in Gilead, said to Ahab, "As the Lord, the God of Israel is, whom I serve, there will neither dew nor rain in the next few years, except at my word." You know, do you know the location, the Tishbite or Tishbe? Where is the Tishbe? I have no idea. I read many Bible commentary and articles. No one talk about the location of tissue box. But I analyzed the Hebrew word. I found something interesting. Oh, by the way, this on whom I serve, new interpretation, international version renders whom I serve, but actually, which means whom I stand before him. Elijah the prophet, he confessed, I am with God. He confessed himself. I'm serving God, that is whom I stand before him. God is really Elijah. And Tishbe, we don't know its exact place, but I guess it means Yahweh enables to dwell. In Hebrew, the Hebrew word Yashab, so repeat after me, Yashab.
Yashab.
Sorry, I'm not teaching, but Yashab means dwell or sit down. And then the preposition T means makes something, create something. So Tishubeh, T plus Yashab. God make us dwell. Elijah, he could leave this world or his world because God let him dwell and sit down. And furthermore, the main issue is about the rain. The First Kings chapter 17 begins with rain. No rain. No rain. Why? Why the narrative talking about rain? Because the time Ahab, the little kingdom of Israel, the king, his name is Ahab, he got married to the woman, her name is Jezebel. Jezebel, she was the daughter of Sidon, the king, and the king, his name Et Baal. So repeat after me, Et Baal. Et in Hebrew means widow. Baal, you know, the god, Canaanite god, Baal. Actually, the Baal means lord or husband. It looks like this. You know, maybe I think last year I mentioned about the Korean comedian, Bang Myung-soo, whoosh. It looks like the Baal. Many idols, you know, escaped when the scholars, they excavated, they couldn't find this kind of a small idol, whoosh. Yeah. Baal, he using thunder. He make rain. You know, in the agriculture society, the Canaan, they need rain, right? That's why the Baal, he using the thunder, he riding the cloud, and that's why so many Canaanite people, they worship Baal. And she, her name is Anat or Asherah. She is the wife of Baal, Baal's wife. Asherah means sacred pole and or productivity. And she, and by worshiping Asherah, and so many Canaanite people, they expect the growth of their productivity and agriculture in society. They need many productivity. That's why Canaanite people, they worship Baal and Asherah. But the problem is, when you read the Bible, the First Kings and Second Kings, so many times the phrase under the leafy tree or under the green tree, so many times, what does it mean? The prophets, they criticized the worshippers under the green tree, under the leafy tree. What happened under the green tree? Under the tree, male prophets for Baal and female prophets for Asherah, they had sexual intercourse under the leafy tree. This is a sexual issue. By, together, sleeping together, they expecting God will send the rain. That's the problem. Do you think who gives us rain and our productivity? Only God gives us rain, right? But the Canaanite people, they expect by worshiping Baal, by worshiping Asherah, and they will send the rain. But bear in mind, God will give you rain and life. Today, so many people, they worship their own gods. Their God could be their money. Some people think that money can solve all their problems. Their God could be their honor or their rank. Some people think that their higher position could solve all the problems. And this man, the Korean, the former minister of the culture department, he's so genius, very intelligent. He's graduated from Seoul National. I'm sorry, so many times I mentioned Seoul. I have no idea. Oh, here's Seoul National University. Seoul National University. He graduated Seoul National University. He's really genius. He's leading the literature, the Korean, the literature. And he is atheist. He was atheist. But his life changed. Before he met God, he only seeking money, his honor. You know, that is his kind of a Baal or Asherah. But one day, he got the letter from her. They each other, they had no good relationship. They never talked to each other, you know, in person when she was young. And she went to the U.S. She became, her name is Mina, Lee is her last name. And she became a lawyer. But she had three children, but she got divorced. And she got, you know, heartbreaking. But that time, she met God. God helped her. And she met God in person. That's why she sent a letter to his father, the first time. He confessed, he wrote about his Bible. First time my daughter sent a letter about the belief. Father, believe in God. It's very, very important to your life. That's why he decided to believe in God. But she passed away because she got the cancer. So heartbreaking. But even though that happening, he decided to believe in God. And she wished that her father delivering her letter moved her father, and he changed his attitude toward his situation. When he opened the window, he could breathe in life of the air. He confessed that God controls everything. My fellows, do not rely on your money, do not rely on your honor, do not rely on your knowledge, only God. You should rely on only God. God provides you with everything. God will guide you into his pasture. Amen. And second, we should follow God's words. So let us read again. We should follow God's words. And let us read 1 Kings chapter 17, verse 2-3. Ready? Go. Then the word of the Lord came to Elijah. Leave here, turn this word, and hide in the creek ravine east of the Jordan. You will drink from the brook, and I have left the ravens to supply you with the food there. So he did what the Lord had told him. Amen. Actually, the pronunciation is difficult. Carried or carried? Carried the ravine. The carried, what does it mean carried? The carried ravine, the east of Jordan, and Elijah is stated there. By the way, do you know what does it mean, the Elijah? Eli means my God. Zah means Jehovah. Yahweh is my God. Elijah, he fled from Ahab to the Wadi Kerit. The Kerit is from the Hebrew word karat. So repeat after me, karat. Karat means to cut. You know, covenant in Hebrew is berit. Berit. So repeat after me, berit. Berit. Berit is from karat, to cut. Long time ago, the ancient Near Eastern society, when somebody needed the contract, they brought animal or dog, and they, with a sword, they cut and separated. And then, for example, me and I crossed over, and B also crossed over. Why? If you disobey my, you know, contract, you will be like this, to cut, cut. Killing is kind of buried, covenant. And Elijah, he just followed the word of God. And he had no idea at that time. He never prepared his food. He just followed the word of God. He went there. Elijah was not afraid of anything. Why? Because he believed Yahweh, Jehovah, is with him. He obeyed God's covenant. We should listen to God's voice and follow his words. In our mind, God is speaking. In our mind, God is speaking. When you pray to the Lord, you can hear the voice of God. When I was in the U.S. in 2018, the May 22nd, that time, I still remember that. And then, wow, that was one of my happiest day. Oh, happy day. I finished my dissertation. I was so, so happy. And I thought, oh, the end. Okay? And then that time, I got the offer from theological seminary, and they offered our faculty the position. And then, but that time, I need to pray to the Lord because my father, he was so sick, and also my father-in-law, he was also very sick. I need to take care of my father and my father-in-law. But right now, I don't have to go back to Korea because offer the faculty position. Wow, what a good job! And then in the night, I pray to the Lord. God, please say to me something. I need to follow your word. And in my mind, I could hear, go to the Korea. Go to your country. That time, in Korea, nobody can text me. But I just followed the voice of God, and with my wife, I came back from, you know, I am here and arrived in the Korea, and suddenly, my senior professors, Yonsei University and Presbyterian University and Theological Seminary, they contacted me. I don't know how could they know my phone number. They contacted me, and they let me teach about the apocalyptic literature and the Bible for college students. And I taught for Yonsei University students and then Presbyterian Theological Seminary students just 1 week. And then somebody contacted me again, Hanam University, they said, yeah, you're gonna be a full-time, you know, chaplain. So I applied. And I got accepted. I came to Daedeok. No relatives live here. Daedeok is not familiar with me. I think during my life, just twice I came here at that time. And then I went to Hanam University for 3.5 years. I served. Really, I spent I spent so much energy for my college student, university student, for Hanam University, right? right? Thank you so much. Right. And then last year, December, somebody contacted me. How about applying Presbyterian University? You know, there is a seminar in Seoul. That's why I applied, and then I got accepted, and I began the new career as a professor for students. You know, just to follow the word of God, just to listen to the voice of God. Elijah, my God is Adonai Yahweh. Yahweh Yahweh, Jehovah, my God, He gave us a covenant, to cut it, cut. Our life, we don't know our future. We don't know our future. Only following God, God will lead you. God will guide you. You know, last Sunday, I received a prayer request. Olivia, he is thinking about, as a communication between Africa and South Korea, right? And then, and also Ellen, and she also so stressful about the paperwork, okay? We have prayer request. You pray to the Lord, who is listening to your voice? God is listening to your voice. And God will listen to your prayer. And God will lead you. Don't be afraid of anything. Just go. Just follow the word of God. God will lead you. Amen. And third, let us read together. God sends His presence in times of need. And let us read 1 Kings chapter 17, verse 6. The ravens brought him bread and meat in the morning, and bread and meat in the evening, and he drank from the brook. Amen. I was very curious. God can send for Elijah dove. You know, raven? When raven first time appeared, do you think? In the book of Genesis, raven? In the Ark of Noah? No. 40 days and nights, raining, okay? And then and at the end of rain, Noah, he opened the windows and he sent raven. Raven never came back. But when Noah sent dove, dove brought kind of olive in the leaves and came back. Raven, we cannot control. Let me show the picture. It's like this, raven. Oh, he is eating something. Here, ravens. Ravens, do you know the nickname of ravens? Scavengers. He is eating dead animals. Very dirty. But God used ravens. By sending ravens, Elijah, he could survive. Very, very surprising, you know. Morning and evening, ravens brought bread and meat. Wow, what a wonderful. It's really a miracle. I found something interesting. Ravens, when I read the raven, when I first time I read the word raven, it's me. Raven, before I believed in Jesus Christ, I was a sinner. I'm a sinner. But God used me like a raven. You know, we believe in Jesus Christ. We confess we are Christians. But think about your life, your past. It's like ravens. We are sinners. But God used us. God sent us, you know, to help others. Look around. Your friends, your neighbors, you can be ravens. God delivered by ravens, right? Even if we are like ravens, scavengers, We can change this world around us. So many people need our support. God will send us to help them with bread and meat. Once God chooses us, God blesses our food. Our food becomes God's delivery. You know, we are sinners. Our food, very dirty. How can we support to our neighbors? But can a change our food. You know, last Sunday, the church bulletin, I talking about the Bible keys, and the Melvin, suddenly he came to me, he said, Pastor, yeah, the end of the June, barbecue party? No, barbecues. He confused the barbecues as a BBQ, barbecue party. Sorry, my pronunciation didn't happen. But I think I'm looking forward to barbecue party together. Yeah, we using barbecue party. It's like a food we share together. And we are so exciting, right? And through our fellowship, we can feel the love of God, the Holy Spirit, right? God bless us all food. My fellows, let us help our neighbors. Let them survive in their fields. We can be God's ravens. Amen. Now let us praise this song together. My heart, your home.
Listen to the voice of God and the ravens and ravens.
always brought food and water for me. But sometimes we just went following the Baal and Asherah, the Anat. We expect that they will bring food and rain. But God will send His food for us and His blessings for us. Father, we want to follow You. Please use us as Your laborers. And let us pray together. Father, thank You for today's message. God's delivered meal by Your laborers. Let us bear in mind that God bless us. Let us remember that God uses us and changes the world through me like a raven. Just as Jesus Christ, He changed this world with His love. Let us change this world with His love. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. And,